Hey everyone, welcome back to another tutorial video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make custom stream overlays with Canva. Before jumping straight into Canva, it's good to already have a theme in mind for your overlays. There are a lot of ways to achieve a consistent theme. You could use motifs, which are a reoccurring aspect of your design, like a single background or image that is used across all scenes, a topic like space or coastal, colors, shapes, and fonts all can help build up a consistent theme. When you get to Canva, the best thing to do is work smart and not hard by utilizing one of their templates. Even if you end up removing every element, you will still have the right aspect ratio in the right format. Search for Twitch screens from the main page. So I've decided that I'm going to build a set of scenes from scratch around the theme of plants or nature. It's just a random category that I chose. And I'm going to start with this template, and I'm probably going to remove most of it, but I really like the social callouts it has at the bottom. You can see down the bottom here our video timeline. By default, it'll be 5 seconds. It doesn't really matter how long this is because we can always loop it in our streaming software like OBS. So first, I'm just going to go through this template and delete all the elements that I don't want to use. And I'm going to center the font and I'm going to say starting soon because that's the scene I'm going to start with. So I've just centered everything with the text tools at the top here, reduced the font size a little bit, and now I'm going to update the bottom. This is a good idea to have on your end screen when your next stream is if you have a standard schedule. I might just remove this because we're already going to have our socials here. I'm going to move our socials up. All right, so now we have some pretty basics, and then the one thing I want to look for is a background. I'm going to try and keep my background image, my colors, and my font style all consistent across my scenes, and that's what's going to build up my theme for me here. So I'm going to go to elements and see what images we have for backgrounds available. I like something like this. It's pretty dark, but I could go with white font or something like this. Okay, this one has a lot smaller elements, so I might run with this one. So I've picked my background image, and with background images, you don't want anything that's going to be too distracting or pull focus from what you actually want people to look at. So right now, this is very bold, and I probably want to lighten it and maybe blur it out a little bit so it doesn't stand out as much. So what I can do is come up here and go to Edit Image, and I can go to the Adjust menu and See All, and then play with these to lighten it up a little bit. And then I can also use the blur tool here to add blur. I want to blur it so it's not distracting, but I don't want to blur it too much where we lose what the actual image is. Okay, I'm going to change the font color to white because I think green and white go really well together. And then I want to keep these fonts white, so I'll probably make these backgrounds a darker color. You'll probably find with Canva that you can change most elements. So this is really coming together. This is a really good start. But like I said, we're starting soon screens. You want some sort of movement so people know the stream is actually running and the stream is working. So I'm going to try and add some movement here. One way we can do this really easy is by animating our text. So if I select my text and come up to animate, I have all these options. So I'm probably going to go with something like this, like typewriter that types out starting soon. Now, I want to keep the plants theme going, but I want to add some graphics in. So I'm going to look for graphics only, and I'm going to look for the ones that are animated. So the ones that have movement, and see how I can add any of these into my design. So I like this one because it has like a growing plant. You also see when you select a graphic, you'll have magic recommendations and you can click see all. And a lot of times it will have see at the top here, related designs or designs that kind of go with the one you've already selected, and you can find some good matches in there. I really like this one too. I can probably make this look like a tree branch or something coming down from this corner. I might duplicate this a couple of times. We kind of get something like this that could look like a bit of a swaying tree happening here. And I might color match these boxes to my leaves if I can. Okay, looking good. Okay, now that I have this, I think I'm going to add a border because the border can really tie everything together, but it can also be used to create depth. And I think I want to have gold. I feel like green, white, and gold are colors that go really well together. So maybe something like this. This is quite thick, but we can reduce it. So if I pull this out, Also, if you're looking for a way to create a color palette and you're not sure what colors go together, there is a website called Coolers. I'll have the link in the description. But it's a tool that a lot of designers use that help you build color palettes really simply with the press of a spacebar. And especially useful if you're unsure on what to use. Okay, so this border box obviously isn't big enough for our whole scene, and you'll probably find this with a lot of borders on Canva. So what I did is cropped off the right side, and then I can go flip and flip this image around, drag it over this side. So now it looks like I have a full border when I use two half borders, and I'm gonna group these together so they can move together throughout the design. And then I'm gonna send them backwards because I want my plants to be over the top of the border. And I probably don't want this border to be as strong and bold as it is right now, so I'm gonna use the opacity slider just to turn this down. All right, and then the last thing I might do here is add a shadow to our font. Okay, that looks pretty good. So what you can do to export this is you can drag out your clip length to however long you want your starting soon screen to be. However, with the font writing, it won't loop if you just have it as one long video. So the other thing you can do is just export a short clip, loop it in OBS, or you can copy and paste this scene down here so that you have multiple consecutive scenes running after another, and set this clip for however often you want your text to run again that's animated. So if I now play this through, you'll have the starting soon text appear, and then it will white vanish and then reappear again. And this is what people will see when they are on your starting soon screen on stream. So now that I have my first scene, I can just take these elements and this theme through to all the other scenes that I want to create. So something really easy we can do is just take the starting soon screen and make it an ending scene very easily just by updating some of the font. And just like that, we're two scenes down. The other ones we can do are a Be Right Back scene. So we can do something like this that matches our starting soon and ending screen, very simple. Or we can add in some different elements. So we can kind of do a little advertising here for ourselves in our Be Right Back screen. What I'm gonna do is remove the plants in this scene, and I'm gonna reduce down these borders, because what we can actually do is you could have a couple of clips here if you have YouTube videos, or you could make these frames fit for TikToks. And then once you're in your stream software, you can actually add in those video clips to run on your Be Right Back screen. Still super clean, super easy. So for gaming scenes and just chatting scenes, I like things that are really clean and simple. I don't like to have a lot of overlay on those screens. But if you do, you could do something like this. So all I've done here so far is created another border for where you would insert your cam, a border for your gameplay or screen would go, and then I'm creating down here the boxes where you would use things like latest follower. And I also want to have some sort of shape over here where I can add the chat box so that the chat box has a background, so the chat's properly visible and isn't against this plant background that we have here. Okay, so I found this that fit in pretty well. And when you're choosing a color for this, you want to think about what color your chat will be, whether it will be a white font or black font, and how it will stand out. So you can test that and always come back here and update this later. We could also add some plants back into this scene. I wouldn't recommend having moving elements on a scene where people are meant to be paying attention to you or gameplay. And so I would keep it simple with like static elements like this little plant image and things like that. And there you have it. We've pretty quickly and easily created some Twitch scenes from templates in Canva. All that's left to do now is come up and download as a video file and import it into your streaming software. I hope this tutorial helped some of you or inspired some of you to refresh your stream scenes. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below and I'll be happy to answer them. Also, let me know if there are any other tutorial type videos you'd like to see. If you like this video, make sure to like it and subscribe to my channel so you can catch any of my future videos. Thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll catch you in the next one.
It's fire. That record be making a scene.